Okay, so here we will apply this formula between linear velocity and the angular velocity for this type of motion, which is a general plane motion. So here we want to find out the relation between VA, VB, and the omega AB, that is the angular velocity of this rod AB, which performs the general plane motion. So if you observe the velocity of A, then this velocity VA, it is perpendicular to the distance AI1. Okay, so this AI1, it will become the radius. Okay, and we can consider complete rod AB, it is rotating about the point I1. Okay, so use the same formula. V is equal to R into omega. Only changes here, velocity, consider the velocity for the point A. So it will become VA. Then consider I1 as the center of rotation. So here we consider the point A as the center of rotation, and VB becomes the tangential velocity or the linear velocity. So similarly here, VA, it will become the linear velocity. Okay, point I1. So this will become the center of rotation. And this distance, that is AI1, it will become the radius. So radius will be AI1 into angular velocity will be complete velocity of the rod AB. Because rod AB, it performs the general plane motion. So this is omega AB. So this is the first relation for link AB. Second relation we can write for the velocity VB. So this is the linear velocity and this is the perpendicular. So it will become the radius. And this is the center of rotation. So we can write VB, this is equal to R into omega. So VB is equal to radius will be BI1 or distance BI1 into omega will be angular velocity omega AB. Okay, so by using this relation, if you know the initial velocity VA, then we can find out the omega AB and the velocity VB. Okay, so all these velocities VA, VB, and omega AB, they are dependent on each other. So now we will solve the problem on the general plane motion. Then you can understand how to apply the given formula V is equal to R into omega. Okay, so refer this problem. So this is the problem on the general plane motion. So what is given in the problem? A collar B, which moves up with some constant velocity, 2 meters per second. A rod AB is pinned to the collar at point B. The meaning of pin is, it is connected by using pin joint. So this is the pin joint, or we can say it is a hinge joint. Okay. So the collar, rod AB is pinned to the collar at point B. The end A of the rod slides on the inclined ground. So this ground has inclination 30 degree. So this is that inclined ground, and the point A, it slides on this ground. And question is, determine the angular velocity of the rod AB. That means we have to find out omega AB and the linear velocity of the end A. That means we have to find out the VA value. Okay. And what is given in the problem? The linear velocity of the point B is given. That is nothing but collar. So VB is given, which is equal to 2 meters per second. Okay. So collar means it is just a sliding element. So this collar, it slides in this rod. So this collar, it will only have the reciprocating motion, or it will have only translation motion. Okay. So point B, it moves in the upward direction. So this is the motion or the velocity direction for the point B. So this is VB. Now, because of this upward motion of the point B, the point A, it will slide on this ground. Okay. So it will have the motion in this direction. So rod AB, it will maintain the contact with this ground, and therefore the point A, it will just slide on this ground. So we can draw the velocity vector for the point B, which is parallel to the inclined plane, like this. So this is the VA. Okay. So if you observe this complete mechanism, then which part of this mechanism will have the general plane motion? That means it will have the translation and the rotation. So if you observe the motion of this rod AB, then it will have the general plane motion. That means rod AB, it will have translation motion, and at the same time it will change the angle, and therefore it will have the rotation motion. Okay. So after some time instant, let us take this as an initial time zero. Okay. So after some time, if the point B, it moves in the upward direction. So this is this new position for the point B. It is B dash position. So let us take this after time interval 2 seconds. And because of this point A, it will shift in the upward direction along this plane. So initially point A is here. So it will take some another position. So this is the new position of the rod AB or this complete mechanism. Okay. So this is the A dash point. This is linear velocity component for the point A. So this is VA. Then velocity component of the point B, it is in the upward direction. So this is VB. Okay. So if you observe this angle, so this is initial angle 40 degree and this is the new angle. Okay. So it will be less than 40 degree. So it may be 30 degree. So if you observe the orientation of the rod AB, then orientation is continuously changing as the point B, it moves in the upward direction. Okay. And therefore the complete rod AB, it performs rotation as well as translation. Because A and B, they are having pure translation, and rod AB, it is changing the orientation, that means angle, and therefore it performs the general plane motion. Now the question is, we have to find out omega AB and VA. To find out omega AB, we have to locate the ICR. Okay. So to locate the ICR, we know the procedure. We have to draw the perpendicular to the linear velocity. So refer this initial diagram, which is a 40 degree inclination of the rod AB with respect to this Y axis. Okay. Now draw the perpendicular to the vector VA. So this is the perpendicular to the vector VA. At the same time, draw the perpendicular to the vector VB at point B. So this is the second perpendicular. Okay. So intersection of these two perpendicular, so this point is nothing but the ICR. So let us take this point as the I1, which is nothing but the instantaneous center of rotation. Now by referring this ICR, we will find out the omega AB, VA and VB. So what is meaning of this ICR I1? For a particular time instant, when the orientation of rod AB is represented by angle 40 degree, this complete rod AB, it is rotating about the point I1 at this time instant only. Okay. So this is the angular velocity of the rod AB, which is omega AB. Okay. Now to find out omega AB, we can use the relation. First is VA. Just consider the linear velocity VA. So this linear velocity VA, it is perpendicular to this line I1A or AI1. Okay. So AI1, it will become the radius. So we can write radius into angular velocity. This is general formula. So we can write VA is equal to, what is radius? So this AI1, it will become the radius into what is angular velocity, is nothing but omega AB. So this is the first relation. Second relation we can write for the VB. So VB is equal to, so radius here is BI1 into angular velocity will remain same. It is a omega AB. Because both the points A and B, they are lying on the link omega AB. Okay. Therefore, omega AB, it remains constant. Only if you change the point, then its radius will change. Now we have to find out this radius by considering the given dimensions. Okay. So observe the given angle. This angle is 30 degree and this is 40 degree. Okay. So first we have to find out this angle, this small angle. So we will construct the right angle triangle. So draw the horizontal line from the point A and draw a vertical line from the point B. So we will get this triangle AMB. So in this triangle AMB, this angle is 40 degree. Okay, this is 90 degree. So this complete angle A, it will become, so this total angle, so it will become 50 degree. Okay. So this total angle is 50. And this small angle, so this small angle, it will become 30 degree. Sorry, 20 degree, because it is 50 minus 30 degree. So this is 20 degree. Okay. So why we calculate this angle? Because we want this angle. So this angle will be 90 minus 20, that is equal to 70 degree. Because this line AI1, it is perpendicular to this inclined surface or this vector VA. Okay. And therefore this angle will be 90 minus 20. So if you consider this triangle AI1 B, so in this triangle, we know this angle 70 degree, then distance AB, that is the length of AB. This is given in the problem, that is equal to 1.5 meter. Okay. And we know this angle, this is 40 degree. This total is 90 because line BI1 is perpendicular to the vector VB. So this is 90 degree. So this angle will be 90 minus 40, that is equal to 50 degree. Okay. Now consider that triangle. So this is I1, this is point B, this is point A. So this angle is 50 degree, this angle is 70 degree, this side is 1.5 meter, that is the length of rod AB. Okay. Now we require distance AI1 and distance BI1. So to find out these two distances, we have to use the sine rule. Okay. So by using the sine rule for the triangle, so for the sine rule, known side is AB, its opposite angle. So let us take this as a theta. Okay, so this theta will be 180 minus 70 minus 50, that is equal to 60. So AB upon sine of opposite angle, that is a sine 60, equal to distance AI1 upon sine of opposite angle, so it is a sine 50, so this angle, and distance BI1 upon sine of opposite angle, that is sine 70. Okay, now consider first two relations. So we can get the AI1, this is equal to AB is 1.5 divided by sine 60 into sine 50. Okay, so you will get the answer for AI1, that is equal to 1.327. So AI1, this is equal to 1.327. Then use first and last relation. So AB upon sine 60 is equal to BI1 upon sine 70. Okay, so you will get the value of BI1, that is equal to 1.627. Okay, so once we get this value, then you can use this relation VA and VB. Just note that VB is given, that is equal to 2 meter per second. So as the VB is given, therefore use this relation. VB is equal to BI1 into omega AB. So VB is equal to BI1 into omega AB. So VB is 2 meter per second. BI1 is equal to 1.627 into omega AB. So you will get omega AB, that is equal to 1.229 rad per second. So this is your first answer. We have to find out the angular velocity of the rod AB. So this is angular velocity of the rod AB. Okay, now we have to find out the linear velocity of the point A. So use the second relation, VA is equal to AI1 into omega AB. So AI1 is known, that is equal to 1.327 into omega AB. This is 1.229. So you will get the VA, this is equal to 1.63 meter per second. Okay, so this is how you can find out the linear velocity and the angular velocity for a mechanism which is having general plane motion. So what is given in the problem? A slider crank mechanism is shown. The crank rotates at 100 rad per second. So this is the angular velocity for the rod OA. Find the angular velocity of the rod AB and the velocity of the slider. Okay, that means we have to find out the angular velocity AB for the connecting rod and the slider velocity, that means linear velocity of the point B. Okay, so to find out these two velocities, your first step is we have to find out the ICR. And to find out the ICR, we have to identify which link performs the general plane motion. Okay, so just by observation, you can give the answer. Rod AB, it will perform the general plane motion. Okay, to find out the ICR, first show the linear component for the point A and point B, that is the velocity component. So as the angular velocity is given for the crank OA in the anticlockwise direction, so linear velocity of the point A will be on the left side. So linear velocity component for the point A will be like this. Okay, and this component VA, it will be perpendicular to the crank OA because this is the linear velocity for the point A. Okay, and because of this linear velocity, the velocity of the point B, it will be towards the left side. So this is linear velocity of the point B. and this velocity will be parallel to this ground, because point B, it will only have the reciprocity motion. Therefore, VB may be leftward direction or it may be rightward direction. Okay, for given time instant, as this velocity is anticlockwise, so this is the omega OA. Okay, and therefore VI is leftward direction and VB is also leftward direction. Now we have to locate the ICR. So to locate the ICR, draw the perpendicular to the vector VA and to vector VB and find out their intersection. So just extend the OA like this and draw the perpendicular from point B . So this is the intersection and this is your ICR. So consider this as a I1. Okay. Now remaining part is we have to find out this distance AI1 and distance BI1, because we can use the formula V is equal to R into omega. So when you consider the point A, write this velocity for the point A, that is a VA. This radius will be distance AI1. Okay. So for the point A, consider point A as a part of AB. Okay. And when point A becomes part of AB, it will rotate about the point I1. So we can use this formula, VA is equal to R will be distance AI1 into this omega will be omega AB. Because right now we are considering the point A as a part of rod AB. Okay, then consider point B. So VB will be distance BI1 into omega AB. Okay, so these two relations we can write by considering the general plane motion of the rod AB. Now consider the pure translation, pure rotation. So pure rotation means we have to consider the point A as a part of this crank OA. So crank OA, it is having only rotation or pure rotation because it is fixed at point O. So when we consider point A as a part of OA, then we can write the relation V is equal to R into omega. So V will be VA because A is the part of rod A, rod OA. Radius will be, now consider this radius, that is the distance OA. So consider this radius as a OA and omega will be the angular velocity omega OA. Okay, so VA is common to crank OA and the rod AB. Now refer the given data. So in the given problem, the crank angular velocity is given. That means omega OA is given. This is equal to 100 rad per second. Then distance OA is given, that is equal to 200 mm, or this is 0.2 meter. So by using this, we can find out the velocity VA. Okay. So we can write this relation VA is equal to OA is 0.2 and omega OA, that is equal to 100. So we will get 20 meter per second. So this is the velocity of the point A. Okay. Now use this velocity to find out the omega AB. So we have to refer this relation. VA is equal to AI1 into omega AB. Okay. So before that, we have to find out the distance AI1. But AI1 is not given directly in the problem. So you have to find out that distance by using the given dimension and by using the sine rule or the cosine rule. Okay. So refer the given diagram. So in the given diagram, this position of the crank, it is given, that is equal to 40 degree, and this angle is given, that is equal to 20 degree. okay, then rod AB distance is not given, but distance OA is given, that is equal to 200 mm, that is equal to 0.2 meter. So by using this 0.2 meter, 40 degree and 20 degree, we can find out the rod AB distance. So first find out this angle. So this angle will be 180 minus 40 minus 20, that is equal to 120. Okay, so if this is 120, this angle will be 180 minus 120, that is equal to 60. This is 20, so this total is 90 degree. So this angle will be 90 minus 20, that is equal to 70 degree. And then this angle, it will be 180 minus 60 minus 70. Okay, so that is equal to 50 degree. Now consider this triangle OAB. So in the triangle OAB, so we have this triangle. This is point B, this is O, and this is point A. This is 40 degree, this is 20 degree, and this is equal to 0.2 meter. Use the sine rule. So by using sine rule, we can write distance OA upon sine of opposite angle, that is a sine 20. This is equal to